Hi there, and welcome back to Healing in the Kingdom of God. This is part two of our five-part series, and today we are going to be talking about what do healing resources in the Kingdom of God look like. Now, you know that you want healing, right? But you have to understand how resources work in the Kingdom of God in order to access that healing. So that is what we're going to be talking about today. I'm Dr. Darlene Mayo. I'm a neurosurgeon and a neuroscientist, and I am here to help you get breakthrough in your health using keys in science that unlock truths in scripture so that you can live out your full potential. All right, so let's talk about this a little bit more. Now, I told you in part one that the reason we have access to healing at all on the earth is because the Kingdom of God exists on this earth now. And as children of God, we are all granted access to the Kingdom of God. It is through the power of the Kingdom of God that Jesus did his healing while he was on the earth, right? So now that you know that you actually have access to healing resources, we need to know what healing resources look like, right? Because let's take another example. Say you are hungry and your goal is to not be hungry anymore. And so you know that there is a fruit that exists that you can eat and you won't be hungry, right? But what if you don't know what that fruit looks like? What if you don't know what trees it grows on or how to find it? Then you're going to be hungry for a long time if that fruit is the only thing that's going to help you not be hungry. Well, healing resources are the same way. If you don't know what you're looking for, then you're not going to recognize it when you find those resources, all right? So there's two principles that you need to understand about the kingdom. One of those we talked about last time, which is this principle of exchange in the kingdom. You don't just go take things out of the kingdom, you bring something to the kingdom, and then you can take something out of the kingdom. It works on a concept of exchange. The other principle in the kingdom is that it is often seed-based, right? So there is something, you go into the kingdom and you get a seed. You don't go in necessarily and get the end result that you're looking for, right? We talk about this sometimes with finances, right? You don't go into the kingdom and just go pull out $10,000, right? You go into the kingdom and the Lord gives you an idea that then you implement and you earn that money, right? So healing works the same way, is there is a seed in there that leads to your healing, and that's what we are going to talk about today. So you want to be healed, right? Let's say that you are blind and you want to be able to see. So what we do normally is we pray for our eyesight to be restored, right? Which is, it's a good prayer, right? But that's not how the kingdom of God works, right? So in the kingdom of God, you're not entering the kingdom of God and getting new eyeballs and putting them in your head, right? What is the seed for healing in the kingdom of God? Well, I will tell you, and I've written about it in my book, The Science of God's Healing Power. The seed for healing in the kingdom of God is energy. Yes, it's actually energy, and it's a very specific type of energy known as light energy. I go through all the details of this in my book, right? Jesus is light. He says, I'm the light of the world. God is light, right? And Jesus's power and the power he used to heal is actually the light energy that is inside him even today, okay? And that is that power that will heal you on the earth today. And folks, for the science behind this, okay, as far as light energy being healing, well, guess what? There's a ton of information about it in my book, but I will tell you, there was a study out of Northwestern University, okay, in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, one of the top medical journals in the world, okay, in 2016, that showed even our DNA has light energy in it and responds to light energy, folks. So light energy is very, very powerful to our bodies, and it is actually the transfer of light energy that is the cause and the cure for every sickness, disease, injury, and yes, even death. So you want the details about that part? Go read about it in my book, okay? I'll drop a link to that underneath this video. But for now, let's talk about that energy and accessing it in the kingdom. So Jesus, how did he heal, right? What resource did he use? He was filled with power, right? So if we look at the book of Mark chapter 5, when Jesus healed, or when his power actually healed the woman who had been bleeding for 12 years, because he didn't even intentionally heal her, right? She touched his robe and got healed. Here's what he said. He felt the power that always surged around him pass through him for someone to be healed, okay? That power, that light energy that's filling him, that is what healed her, okay? And that was transferred, that energy was transferred a lot of the times through touch. You know that Jesus touched people and then he healed them. And in fact, the scripture tells us that every person that Jesus touched was healed, okay? It is just a principle that when that light energy passes into you, it can correct the energy problem that caused you to be sick in the first place. And this is the basis for my scientific folks out there who are familiar with the practices of acupuncture and Reiki, right? So in acupuncture, the theory is that you have energy that has been transformed in your body into a form that it should not be, or it is located in a place that it should not be, right? And the acupuncture actually helps to restore that energy to its natural state and natural location. Then Reiki, on the other hand, works on the principle of drawing out unhealthy energy, right, and replacing it with healthy energy. So that's more external. Acupuncture is more an internal process. Reiki is more an external process, but it is all energy based. And guess what, folks? The energy from acupuncture, the chi that you hear about, and Reiki with the biofield, guess what that is? Scientists have discovered that is actually infrared light, okay? So this is a principle that is present. It's present in science and it's present in the scripture. And healing, light energy, that is the resource that you need to be healed in the kingdom of God. That is your healing resource. And so next time we are going to talk about practically what in the world does that look like, okay? Because I am going to give you some very, very simple steps that anybody can do. This does not cost you any money, right? That you can do, and you can access this healing light energy from God, and you can be healed starting today. So if you liked this video, please like, please share, please comment, and let us know your thoughts. And then go check out my book, The Science of God's Healing Power, Revealing Truth in the Kingdom of God. It's available on Amazon. It's also available in digital at www.scienceofgodshealingpower.com.